Dinosaurs have filled our imaginations for generations. But is what we picture accurate? Representations of dinosaurs in popular media have already developed so much over the past century as we analyse the fossils they left behind. But some paleontologists still believe we have failed to capture what they were really like.
Dinosaurs probably weren't as exciting as we'd like to make them, right? I mean, you know, they were just normal animals. So people who are trying to sell something, whether it be a TV show or a movie, are going to sensationalize the behaviors of animals.
That's Jack Horner, who inspired the character of Dr. Alan Grant in Steven Spielberg's Jurassic Park.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
Who is outspoken in his views about how dinosaurs behaved and looked.
We have a lot of T-Rex skeletons. We still argue about, you know, how they got their meat. I'm still a strong advocate of T-Rex being an opportunist. Mm-hmm. The people that think that it's an apex predator, I think you have to think that just based on opinion and their own biases, because there's no evidence for it. I mean, there's people say, well, there's a broken off tooth in such and such an animal and it mm-hmm. survived afterwards. That's, you know, N of one. I mean, that doesn't show me how. First off, I always say, show me some toys and show me exactly how the T-Rex had to bite this animal in mm-hmm. order for a tooth to be lodged in the centrum of a vertebrae and not alter the neural spine, which is the most fragile part of the thing. How do you actually break a tooth off inside of the hard part of the bone and not disturb the fragile part of the bone? But, mm-hmm. you know, it just doesn't make any sense unless, of course, the animal was laying down on the ground already. I mean, it just, people have their biases. I mean, they want first off, lots of scientists just want T-Rex to be an apex predator. And so they're going to do science the opposite way it's supposed to be done. They're going mm-hmm. to look for evidence to support their theory rather than falsify it. You know, since the beginning of finding dinosaurs, people have been making them, you know, gray and brown. Mm-hmm. And yet their descendants can be very colorful, right? Vividly colored. And I say, since we don't know, I mean, what's a vividly colored dinosaur is just as accurate as a brown one. I mean, we don't know, right? So actually the preponderance of evidence suggests that they would be vividly colored because mm-hmm. their closest, you know, birds are dinosaurs. So if they can be vividly colored, and especially, you know, the dinosaurs with crests, the birds with crests on their heads, you know, or on their snouts or whatever, you know, curassows and hornbills and all those things, all of those bony crests are colorful. They're vividly colored. And so why not at least vividly color, you know, the accoutrements on the heads of the dinosaurs, like the horn dinosaurs and the, you know, and the duckbill dinosaurs and so forth. I mean, why not? A lot of times people just, you know, like the idea that, you know, they're big and therefore they should be like a mammal. Yeah. But mammals evolved as nocturnal creatures. They're mm-hmm. mostly colorblind. I mean, they communicate via pheromones. I mean, they sniff one another. They're not into visual kinds of things like birds and other reptiles are. So what's the point of making a gray dinosaur when we know that they, you know, were not colorblind like most mammals? I mean, it just, you know, it's senseless.
Dinosaurs were likely vividly colored, according to Horner. Surely this doesn't apply to, say, T-Rex. When most people think of T-Rex, they probably imagine a big gray-brown monster. Does Jack Horner think this is scientifically accurate?
Scientifically accurate. You know, we don't know they're accurate. I mean, I just don't like us, you know, staying in with one thing that we don't know is right. I mean, making gray and brown dinosaurs just, you know, is not You know, it may be accurate. I don't know. I mean, we don't know. Mm. But a colorful dinosaur is just as accurate. Mm. And so there's no reason not making them colorful. There just isn't. I mean, and especially, you know, the feathered ones. I mean, birds aren't all gray. Some of them are. They're not all brown, but some of them are. The males of most birds, you know, are very colorful. And why not make, you know, dinosaurs the same way? I mean, it boggles the mind. Within the last year or two, there was somebody made a model of Sue the T-Rex. And, you know, it was a big giant, you know, it looked like a big giant hippopotamus. It was all gray. I mean, it's just mind-boggling that people would make it giant gray. I mean, it just, I don't understand that at all.
Yep.
Why not make it pink? I mean, really, seriously.
Yeah.
You know, I say there's no reason T-Rex couldn't have been feathered and pink and danced and sang. Mm. And everybody just laughs at that. But, you know, the idea is just as accurate as a big hippopotamus gray colored thing.
Mm. Yeah. And, you know, it's more interesting.
And it's more interesting. That's right. It's more fun.
Unleash your inner Velociraptor and discover Jack Horner's theories on dinosaurs in issue 98 of Cosmos magazine. And for the full prehistoric scoop, tune in to the Cosmos podcast, available wherever you get your podcasts. Don't miss out.